Soil background is an important factor to consider when conducting human health and ecological risk assessments. Regulators use numerical screening values specific to contaminants commonly found in soil to evaluate potential risks to people and the environment. For some chemicals, the screening value may be within the range of concentrations found in soils from natural or anthropogenic ambient background. Because most regulatory agencies do not require action to be taken if the amount of a chemical in soil is within the range of background concentrations, soil background plays an important role in remedial decisions. The ITRC Soil Background and Risk Team created four videos to highlight the ITRC 2021 guidance document. Video 1 is the Introduction to the Soil Background and Risk Assessment Guidance. Video 2 covers sampling and analytical methods. Video 3 discusses how to develop default and site-specific background and use them in risk assessment, as well as the development of preliminary remediation goals. Video 4 presents how to use geochemical evaluation and environmental forensics in evaluating background in risk assessments. The Soil Background and Risk Guidance and the training videos and training schedules are found on the ITRC website. This video describes the purpose and overall content of the guidance document, presents the key definitions of natural background and anthropogenic ambient background, and discusses some of the limitations. The ITRC guidance document is designed to provide comprehensive guidance regarding establishing and using soil background values in risk assessment. It focuses on the process of establishing defensible background concentrations of naturally occurring chemicals like metals or anthropogenic substances such as PAHs to be used for risk assessment at contaminated sites. The guidance also includes definitions and regulatory framework. This ITRC guidance document recognizes that although some state and federal agencies and other entities have guidance documents regarding soil background, there is not one comprehensive and widely accepted guidance document that summarizes the state of the science on this topic. It is intended to fill the gap by providing a comprehensive, defensible framework for establishing and using soil background in risk assessments. One of the state survey questions asked if state agencies recommend the use of soil background values in risk assessment. Out of 38 state responses, Figure 12-2 from the guidance shows 92% recommended the use of background values in risk assessment. Half of the surveyed states established statewide or regional soil background values for some chemicals, as shown in Figure 12-3. Natural soil background has been defined in multiple federal and state guidance documents. As stated in Section 2.1, natural soil background is defined as the concentration of a substance or family of closely related substances, for example, similar element species or similar compounds, present in soil due to geological characteristics, natural processes, or releases from non-anthropogenic sources. Section 2.1 covers more details and examples of natural background. For example, arsenic is naturally occurring in many soils throughout the United States from rock weathering and other natural processes. In this graphic, the naturally occurring arsenic is represented by the green icons.
For purposes of this document, anthropogenic ambient soil background is defined as the concentration of a substance or family of closely related substances present in soil due to anthropogenic non-point sources, especially when chemicals have the ability to be transported long distances. Other state-specific definitions, applications, and examples of anthropogenic background are detailed in Section 2.2. When establishing anthropogenic ambient soil background, it is important to carefully consider the intended purpose and clearly define anthropogenic ambient soil background to identify which sources should and should not be included in the risk assessment. An example of anthropogenic ambient background is when PAHs are released into the air from many different locations and migrate over far distances and then settle onto the soil. Now, let's talk about how to differentiate between natural background and contamination. PAHs released from non-anthropogenic sources, like forest fires, can be transported long distances and deposited onto and remain persistent in the soil. PAHs released from forest fires are considered natural background. PAH contamination coming from anthropogenic ambient background are represented by the blue icons. PAH contamination coming from the factory is represented by the orange clouds. This graphic shows how PAH contamination in soil can be mixed with PAHs from anthropogenic ambient sources, as shown in the orange icons. This animation depicts how arsenic from different sources can impact a site. Arsenic can also be present in soil as a result of contamination. Before World War II, arsenical pesticides were commonly used in apple orchards. Frequently, near loading docks and other storage preparation areas, this is illustrated by the orange icons. The background of arsenic is the amount of a substance present in soil due to natural processes, such as weathering. It may be important for project remedial goals to understand how much arsenic is present from background and how much are from site activities. Please note limitations to the ITRC guidance. It is not intended to provide specific soil background values for chemicals. However, it is intended to support risk-based decision-making and complement, not replace, existing regulatory guidance. It is important to keep in mind to review the regulatory framework and the policies of the lead agency to understand their requirements. The guidance does not provide in-depth details for sampling and analytical methods, statistics, geochemistry, and forensics. This is a general introduction to the 2021 ITRC guidance document, Soil Background and Risk Assessment. There are 3 additional videos in this series. For specific topics, refer to the individual sections or other videos in this series, and please visit itrcweb.org for more information.
The Interstate Technology and Regulatory Council is a nonprofit research program of the Environmental Council of the States. ITRC is a state-led organization composed of over 1,000 members from state agencies, federal government, tribal and international organizations, the private sector, academia, and community stakeholders. Members participate in technical teams which produce guidance, tools, resources, and training materials. If you'd like to be a part of ITRC, please visit the ITRC website at itrcweb.org. You can register for teams and learn more about how you can be an active member. ITRC's usage policy is available on the ITRC website. If you do plan to use ITRC materials, we ask that you review that policy in detail and be sure to credit ITRC. ITRC does not warranty the material nor endorse any specific products.